If you are looking for a clutter-free kickstart, something that is going to take the guesswork out of what to get rid of, then here are 10 things that you can declutter this month. Let's go. Hi guys, it's Laura, and by the time you watch this, it will be my daughter's 8th birthday, and in just a few weeks, it will be my birthday. I'm a little bit older than 8. But anyway, so this got me thinking about one great thing that you could declutter this month, and that is greetings cards, you know, birthday cards, anniversary cards, all of those types of things. If you're like me, you tend to hang on to them, but they can take up so much space. So now is a good time to go through. You don't have to go through your entire card collection if you've got a massive amount of them, but go through, keep the most recent ones from people that you love, and then any that have a special message. You know, over the years I have got multiple cards from various different people, and a lot of them are just, you know, have a great birthday type cards, and those are lovely, and I do, like I said, like to keep the most recent one. But all of the others, when I've got like 50 different cards that all essentially say the same thing, it's time to let the other 49 go. Now is a great time to whittle down your collection of greetings cards, postcards, things like that. Okay, let's bring you over here for this next one, and that is phone contacts. Go through and declutter any that you don't recognize the name of. You probably have a Mary in your phone or something like that, and you have no idea who that person is. You knew at the time, of course, but now, listen, we have all been going through quite a year. If you have not contacted that person in the past year, when everyone has been reaching out digitally, etc., chances are you're not going to contact that person. So take just a few minutes, scan through your list of contacts. If there's someone there you have no idea who they are, it's probably time to delete them. Going forward then, something that you can do, something that I do that has proved really helpful, is in the kind of section in my phone, like in iPhones, I don't know if it's the same with Android, but there's usually a section for like what company they work for, or a place to write some notes or something. That is where I write down how I know that person or who they are. So sometimes it will be like neighbor or something like that. So that's how I remember. It's also a good time to update your contact, so that if you have an address for that person, for example, put it into your phone contact so all of their contact information is all together, like their birthday, all that type of thing, all together in one place, so that you don't have to carry around a separate address book. And then there's a bonus one for you: get rid of your physical address book once you have transferred everything over to your phone, and back it up, of course. Okay, let's walk and talk. The next one then is media that you consume on a regular basis. I am talking like a feed reader, if you follow multiple different blogs. I'm talking your YouTube subscription list, even if it's me, all of those types of things, like your DVR, TV shows that you have recorded, anything like that, podcast subscriptions, any media that you consume, digital media, on a regular basis, now's the time to go through those lists and whittle them down. The great thing about going through lists like this is that not only are they going to save you time kind of in the moment — it's getting really dark here, let's go in here — they'll save you time in the moment, but they will also save you time moving forward. Now it's got really bright. Oh, lads, stairs still kill me. I'm gonna have to get my exercise on. But going forward, every week, if you are not reading a particular blog post, if you're not watching a particular video, that's going to save you so much time. And obviously all of that time is going to add up. So let's say you unsubscribe from a YouTube channel, like I said, even if it is mine, then you might be saving yourself 10, 20, 30 minutes a week not watching videos from that particular creator. Now, obviously, if you love the content, keep watching it, but just go through and see if there's anything that just is no longer interesting to you, is no longer providing value to you. Then it's time to cut ties and free up all of that valuable time for yourself. Okay, because we're here then, let's talk bed clothes. So we are moving into a new season. It is spring. It's kind of summer is on the horizon. Not quite here yet, but the weather is heating up. In the southern hemisphere, you probably have the opposite problem. Things are starting to get a little chilly. So chances are you may be reconsidering or changing out your bed clothes. So now is a great time to go through them and declutter all of that old stuff, stuff that is worn, torn, ripped, etc. You can donate all of those things to an animal shelter. They will be very grateful for that stuff. But even if you have something that is not worn out, it's still in good, serviceable condition, but you know that you just haven't used it and you're not going to use it, it's just surplus to requirements, you can just donate that to your local charity. Now, I can't give you kind of a set number of bedclothes that you should keep. It will obviously depend on how often you change them, whether you have, you know, young kids, how often you have guests, things like that. But generally, I would say two sets of bedclothes for each bed is usually enough. And listen, I don't want to start any controversy on this one, but if you have a lot of throw pillows or decorative pillows, consider decluttering those. If you love them, if they look great on your bed and you have no problem arranging them every morning and taking them off every night, that's great. You do you. That's wonderful. But if you find that it's just a pain to put them back on the bed every morning and take them back off every night, and you're really just doing it because of the aesthetic, but actually on a day-to-day basis, it's more annoying than anything, you can probably declutter those. I keep things very basic, very minimal here. We've got a blanket, a sheet, and pillows. That's it. Makes dressing the bed a very quick affair. Matter of seconds, just straighten things up, good to go. In a similar vein then, any other types of linens, so towels, tea towels, cloths, cloth napkins, hand towels, etc. All those types of things, go through them, see if any are past their prime. Again, anything that is worn out or shredded or has holes in it or anything can be donated to an animal shelter. This is one of those areas where I feel like over a lifetime, you know, as you grow up, you tend to accumulate all of these things, like all of these towels just appear from nowhere. And sometimes you get them as gifts, maybe a wedding gift or something like that. And we all just tend to buy them. I don't know, like tea towels and things are just so easy to buy, and you can buy seasonal ones. You know, you can buy ones for Thanksgiving or Christmas or Halloween or whatever. So over the years, they tend to build up and up. And even though we're buying them, we don't always declutter them because technically they are useful. But there is no point in keeping all of that stuff unless you're actually using it. If you have 20 cloth napkins and you never use them, I'm not a cloth napkin type of gal, but if you've got loads and you hardly ever use them, consider getting rid of them. Let's move over here then and you will see why. Books. Our local library is currently closed for renovations. I knew that they were going to be renovated, but I didn't know when. So when I went last Friday and they were shut, I was like, ooh, there was a sign outside saying they're not going to be back open for 2 months. I almost had a little mini panic attack, and I don't know why, because it's not like I'm short of reading material. But anyway, like I said, we're into a new season, so you may find that you are a seasonal reader. You know, if you're coming into summer, you may switch to kind of lighter, more lighthearted reads. If you're coming into winter, you might prefer those more cozy reads. There are all sorts of different kind of seasonal books that we may not even be aware that we are transitioning through, but now is a great time to go through and see if there are any books that are on your shelves that have been there for a while that you have not yet read. Now's a good time to donate those. Like, the library will have reopened by the time I get through all of these books, and even if I get through them in record time and the library for some reason is still not open, I have hundreds waiting for me on my Kindle, and there's also another library in the next town over that I can go to and did in fact go to last Friday. But yeah, books are basically my life's blood, so I know how difficult it can be to declutter them. But look, if something has been there for a long time, it's something that I have in the past kind of year or two really become more conscious of. If there's a book that's just not really grabbing me, old me, like the perfectionist me, would have stuck with it because once I started a book, I wanted to finish it. But now I'm kind of like, look, there are hundreds of books waiting for me on my wish list alone, and never mind the tens of thousands sitting in the actual physical library. I really do not need to stick with every single book I start. If I'm not really inclined to pick it back up, or even to pick it up in the first place, That's a good indication that it may be time to let someone else enjoy that book. I like to think of it as giving someone else the gift of reading, the love of reading, creating new bookworms all around the world. So if you've got one that's just not grabbing you for whatever reason, pass it along. Share the love. Okay, let me move you over here for this next one. Can you see? Can you see? To not think this through. There we go. Okay. Jewelry. Let me straighten you up. Okay. Costume jewelry, fine jewelry. It doesn't matter what you have. You probably have pieces in there that you have not worn. Maybe you have just outgrown, or like I said, because we're in a new season, maybe it's something that you are not going to wear. Maybe it's kind of heavy and chunky and you're coming into spring, summer, whatever. Maybe you always used to wear fine, expensive jewelry and now you're more going for the costume, chunky jewelry, or vice versa. Maybe you're at a stage where you're just not willing to deal with like little fiddly clasps or anything like that. For me, because I work a lot on my laptop, I'm sitting down, I don't like wearing bracelets because they just tend to like clang and bang off my desk or my laptop. Maybe you've got rings that no longer fit, or earrings that have lost their mate. Maybe you've got a broken chain that you've been meaning to get fixed, but it's been like 5 years now and you just haven't. Whatever the reason, there may just be jewelry in there that you have outgrown or just moved past. So give your jewelry box a quick sweep, see if there's anything that you can get rid of, and then just organize the rest. And because I know I will get questions about this, I always do every time I show it. This is actually for makeup. It's a big giant box that is technically designed for cosmetics, but I use it for jewelry. I will link it, or if I can't find it, a similar one in the description box. Next up then is loungewear. Listen, if you have not worn it in the past year when everyone has been wearing loungewear 24/7, chances are you're not going to wear it. Or maybe you have been wearing it 24/7 and you have worn it out. Go through all of your pajamas, the things that you basically wear as pajamas, the comfy clothes that you wear around the house that you wouldn't necessarily wear outside the house, dressing gowns, slippers, fleecy socks, all those types of things. Check the condition that they're in and just ask yourself if you do actually want to wear them or if you will ever wear them again. Like I said, if you haven't worn them in the past year, you're not going to wear them. But even aside from what has been going on in the world, again, because we're in a new season, you may find that you now need lighter things so you can pack away the heavier, bulkier things, or vice versa. If you've been wearing something all winter and you know it's not going to see another winter, you know, it has paid its dues, it has done its job, it has served you well, it's time to pass that on. And by pass it on, I mean, you know, like recycle it or throw it in the trash, depending on the condition. Okay, let me bring you back downstairs for this next one, and that is outdoor decor. So anything that you have outside your house that is purely for decorative purposes. Maybe you have solar powered lights, or you know, fairy lights strung up. Maybe you have garden gnomes, etc. I don't know what you have. Maybe it's even patio furniture or something like that. It's a good time to have a look at that, see what condition it's in, see if it's going to last another season or not, and if you can, try and whittle down your collection. Our outside space is definitely in need of some sprucing up. Few things here that can find new homes. Are you awake? Is it time to get up? Another one then, let me just bring you down here, is writing implements. Pens, markers, fine liners, all those types of things. Go through them, or go through a handful of them at least. I've got little pots of them here. And just grab yourself a piece of paper and scribble and make sure that they actually still work. Go around your home, gather up as many as you can, because pens are one of those types of things that just disappear. As soon as you put them down, they're gone. So get yourself a little pot or a pencil case or something like that, or just put them all together in one drawer so that when you're looking for one, you know where to go. But you will also know when you get there that the one that you pick will actually work. Is there anything more frustrating than like searching the house for a pen, finally finding one, and then it's out of ink? So yeah, writing implements is thing number 10 to declutter. And now I've got to go let the dog out, but if you want more things to declutter, because this is a monthly series, I will link the rest for you. And until next time, go have mila magwev. Agus feicim mé sibh sí go luath. Slán!